Well, there's been a lot of talk about college football playoffs as of late, and the Marion Knights know a thing or two about playoff success. A 45-14 win at St. Francis on Saturday has the Knights headed back to the NAIA National Championship game, where they have a rematch waiting for them in 2 weeks in Daytona Beach, Florida. But before that, they are here tonight with us on Sunday Sports Xtra as we welcome the Knights here with us. Head coach Mark Henninger joining us here, senior linebacker Jamar Wilhite, junior wide receiver, and all-around offensive guy Krishawn Hogan, coming off of a great performance yesterday there at St. Francis. Coach, it's got to be gratifying to put the work in like that and see your kids go up and perform like they did on Saturday with this game.
It is, absolutely. Yeah, they it's a hard-working group, you know, and they've worked really hard here for a year. You know, we got back from Daytona a year ago, and the game didn't finish the way we wanted to finish it, and the season didn't finish the way we wanted to finish it. And while we were certainly happy to, you know, to be one of two teams left playing, it didn't end the way we wanted it to end. So, you know, our guys set as our motto, start to finish. And, you know, we had guys get work right away. You know, we had guys in the weight room on Sunday when we got back from Daytona a year ago,
yeah,
just, you know, starting to work. And these two guys here worked their tails off over the offseason, the summer. And it is. It's hard to get to where we got. But it's nice to see hard work pay off.
Yeah, and Jamar, to kind of get back to it again, now that you have this game ahead of you now, to see the kind of season that it's been, though, to really earn this trip the way that you guys did, it's got to feel pretty good at this point.
Well, it feels tremendous. I mean, It's like you said, from start to finish, we put our heads down, we just go to work, and like I said before, we take it day by day, game by game. That's where we're going to go.
Krishawn, redemption is a word we've kind of thrown around here, but that's the kind of thing that I think has popped up, particularly with this tourney run here. You guys have felt like you want to get back and get this next chance at the title.
Yeah, definitely. I just feel like we want to be really focused, but at the same time, like, we were here last year, I think we were a little tight last year, so this time we want to be focused, but just more experienced and just ready for the situation.
Does it feel different this time versus where you were after the semifinals last year?
Yeah, it feels a lot different. Like, I don't know, last year we were just kind of like, we were so happy to be there.
Sure.
And this year we're just like, we're so focused on just after the game, like after we win, and just taking care of business.
Mark, we were watching the video that we had of the post-game celebration yesterday, a little more, I want to say, business as usual. Act like you've been there before,
yeah,
was the kind of thing that came up. You had a group here that they know there's one more.
Yeah, I mean, we were really excited, you know, because any time you get a win, the schedule that we play, anytime you get a win, you're going to be excited about it. And we were. I mean, yesterday felt great. You know, there's no question. And I think in a lot of ways, I think our guys were somewhat relieved, you know, because, you know, you'd worked so hard and, you know, to finally get to the point, okay, we've done it, we've taken care of all the stuff we need to take care of to get back to have another chance to do it right. And so I do think there was a sense of relief there yesterday, but, you know, yeah, we have been there before, you know, and I think, yeah, I'm really happy with how our guys performed and played and you know, and, you know, as great as yesterday was, we told them right after that was never, our goal was never to get back to that game. Our goal was to, you know, get to next week. So, you know, it feels good to have accomplished that.
Jamar, defensively, you guys came out very aggressive game plan, it looked like yesterday, but you executed it well, it seemed, from start to finish. Just kind of tell me the vibe of the group going into the game. You guys really seem to have things dialed in.
Yeah, I mean, when it comes to defense, I mean, everybody wants to feed off everybody, you know, so it starts up front with the D-line first, goes to the linebackers and then secondary. So as long as everybody's operating on the same time, the same frame, we're going to be great.
You guys have seen a wide variety of very good offenses this season. Has that made this group better, though, you think, as the season's gone on?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely has. Because it's a new game plan every week. So some stuff that happened the week before might be different this week as far as calls, checks and stuff. But, I mean, like I said, as long as everybody's on the same page, we're going to be good, whether the call is good for the play or wrong for it.
Coach, the football IQ of this group is off the charts, it seems.
Mm-hmm.
He talks about learning kind of essentially a different scheme or a different game plan, yeah, a wide variety each and every week.
Yeah, our coaches do an outstanding job. I mean, it's we work really hard, and we spend a lot of time in film study and looking at tendencies and trying to put our guys in the best possible position. And like Jamar said, it's, you know, week to week, it's different. You know, what worked against St. Francis, you know, may not have worked against Grandview or vice versa. So, you know, what worked against St. Francis may not work against Southern Oregon. So, you know, it's a completely different game plan. It's a completely different approach every time we take the field.
Krishawn, we see you listed as wide receiver, but more often than not, when we're running highlights, we're seeing you at quarterback back there. Tell me about when you got a chance to get a look at the game plan coming out of this, and coach kind of came to you and said, hey, we're going to put you back there taking snaps. Had you done that before at any point during your career? Football, high school, middle school, any of that? Fill me in here.
So I did play a little bit of quarterback growing up, and then a little bit in high school before I switched to receiver, like my junior year. But never in college. And then we put it in the last week of the regular season, and I thought that, you know, it was just something to give a team going into the playoffs something else to look at.
Sure.
And then we found a lot of success with it, so we just, I guess, have been sticking with it, and it's really exciting, so I'm fine with it. You know, I like it.
To 14 touchdowns in the span of these last three games is the way my numbers are looking at here. Did you have any idea that it would succeed as well as it has when you added that wrinkle to your offense?
It's something that you know, Coach Mitchell has had for a while, and it's you just got to have a guy that can do it, you know, and Hayden's going to get mad at us when we say that Hayden can't do it. But, you know, Hayden scrambled and yesterday and took about 8 minutes off the clock on his 20-yard run. So it's not exactly his deal, you know, but Krishawn fits. I mean, it's something that, you know, he's excited about. He likes to throw the ball around in practice and, you know, pretend like he's a quarterback. So we said, all right, well, put your money where your mouth is, big boy, and see what you can do.
Kind of living the dream there. You kind of were the other guy kind of in high school over there at Warham. Now you kind of get to be the guy every few plays here and there. It's got to be enjoyable for you.
Yes, it really is.
A rematch coming up with this one here. Let's talk just for a minute about this Southern Oregon game coming up. What can you take away from the last one to get ready for this one? Do you have a sense this is a similar team that you're going to face this year?
Yeah, they're similar in that they're good.
Sure.
You know, I mean, we were just talking, you know, before we got started here that, you know, offensively, I think they're a little bit different. They had a great quarterback a year ago. They've got a really good quarterback again back, but he's a different type of player. So offensively, they've adjusted. Defensively, I think they're pretty much the same. You know, the thing we're going to take away from last year's game is that, you know, you're going to play a good team. You know that they're going to play inspired, and they play, you know, they're fast, they're really athletic. That hasn't changed.
Yep.
You know, but again, it's, you know, it's a different game. It's a different year. Two different teams are coming at the thing. And, you know, we're just excited that we're going back.
The playoffs, and we got all excited about this is the big selection day for football, you know, Division One. But you guys, Jamar, let's talk about this. You guys, this playoff thing, you've had this one-and-done thing to deal with. There's nothing odd about this. You guys have had to deal with this for three straight weeks now. Pressure in games like this? Do you guys feel pressure? What's the mentality going into this?
I wouldn't say so much pressure, but, I mean, we know in the back of our mind, like, our backs are against the wall.
There
so we're going to have to fight just to get by, and nobody's going to lay down for us. It's not going to be easy.
Krishawn, you get the sense that you get everybody's best every week at this point?
Definitely. Yeah, and like he said, nobody's going to just lay down. Everybody's going to give us their best game. So we know that we have to come out with a good game plan and then execute it as well.
Good. 2 weeks, December 19th, you'll have your little inspiration to go with this season. I'm going to reach back here and grab this, and you guys can kind of fill me in on what you got going here. Coach, I'll let you kind of start the story, and I'll let you guys chime in on what this has meant to the team this season.
It's meant a lot. That's the bat call right there. So, you know, last year we were fortunate to get hooked up with a great young man and a great family and Cole Winnefeld. And, you know, our players really, it was I didn't know really how the thing was going to take off. I mean, it was our second to last game of the season last year. We were brought together with the Winnefeld family, and it was, you know, the thing that at first almost was like it's just going to be kind of a one-day deal, but then our guys really rallied around it, and he became a part of our team, and you know, he just watching him battle and fight, and, you know, he fought cancer. You know, he fought cancer for 5 years. He was an 11-year-old boy and you know, just fought valiantly and right up to the end. So really taught our players, you know, a huge lesson, and it's just an unbelievable family, and the whole Marion community, not just our team, but the whole Marion community has really gotten behind it, and you know, this is we've got one of these hanging up in our locker room, and this guy goes on the road with us everywhere, and it's I think it means a lot to our guys.
Yeah, Jamar, too. It goes kind of beyond football, something like this, and you guys have really had a chance to really get attached to it.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's inspiration because it shows that you're fighting for something that's bigger than yourself. Mm-hmm. And as a team, we take that to heart, you know?
Krishawn, a rallying point for you guys kind of when you need that little extra bump?
Definitely. We always talk about what do you play for? And like, what's better than this right here? We got the logo on our helmet as well, so we never can forget, and we're just going to keep playing hard for him.
Yeah, very cool. There you go. Good, making the trip to Daytona with you guys. On,
absolutely.
Yeah, dynamite. Yep. That's good. Well, excellent. Good. Mark, good luck to you here.
Yeah, Brad,
coming
thank
week, Jamar. Krishawn, there you thank go. You. Marion Knights, Southern Oregon, December 19th. Be the title game down there, and I wish you guys all the best in preparation trip down there as well. So we'll take time out here on Sports Xtra. We will have more for you when we come back right here tonight on RTV6.